My name is Ela, and I worked alongside Ilya, Zarya, Mika, and Lea to give you a presentation about Iceland. First of all, I'm going to tell you something about where Iceland is located. Iceland is a northern Atlantic island, which is pretty self-explanatory. It's an island located in the northern Atlantic, and just as a fun fact, it's the westernmost country in Europe. Now I'm going to tell you a little something about the languages used in Ireland, Iceland. Icelandic is its official language, but English and Danish are also used and are official language, with English being the second, and it is known by most Icelandic people living in Iceland, and Danish is the third official language. The language itself is pretty unique because Iceland is so remote from other European countries. And they have a lot of literature that is also due to Iceland being pretty isolated, and that people have a lot of time, especially during the winter, to write and express themselves in a literary way.
Iceland has some traditional but certainly not everyday dishes. For example, they prepare harotiskur, which is a type of fish usually caught, catfish or haddock. Jula tetra, or also known as devil's cake, is a basic chocolate cake. They also prepare sheep's heads and shark's fins. Iceland people have lots of traditions inspired by the pagan and Christian religion. A popular thing among the people are folk tales, which usually include ghosts, elves, or trolls. Almost every tradition or custom is inspired by the old beliefs.
What you can see in Iceland. Here you can find fjords, volcanoes, national parks, northern lights and glaciers. As you can see on the picture, fjords are especially extended in the Iceland. This is because of the location of the Iceland, which lies on the far north. Here you can see the volcanoes in Iceland. The major ones are Hekla, Askja, Hekla, and so on. Some of them are still active today, therefore they are not able for visitors, while the others are inactive and they represent a big tourist attraction.
When you go to Iceland, you must visit at least one glacier. They can be found in the higher parts of the mountains. With their shapes and colors, they make it look like it's magic. Some people also visit Iceland to see the northern lights. It's very special, and if you see them, you're very lucky and you can consider it a miracle. What you can also do is ice climbing, horse riding, hiking, sightseeing, shopping, visiting museums, relaxing in spas, bathing in geothermal pools, and getting to know the culture.
Iceland's main economy comes from manufacturing, industries and tourism. They are also known for their free markets, and because of their free market, they developed a social system which provides education and healthcare to everyone, no matter in which class they belong to. They also are known for their use of geothermal energy in homes and industries, and because of that they are considered as a green country. They have a vast renewable energy resources such as geothermal energy and hydroelectric energy, and because of that they are the largest producer of energy in per person.
Now I'm going to tell you something about the political system in Iceland, because Iceland is a part of the European Union and is situated on the borders of the Union. It has to have the so-called Schengen border patrols. Those are borders that can only be crossed if you are either a citizen of the European Union or you have a special pass. And that border is among 22 countries. All of them are on the premises of the European Union, Iceland being one of them. The country itself is led by the president, although the executive power comes from the government, which is led by the prime minister. This is really now common in the European Union, although it was supposed to be vice versa, therefore making the president the most powerful person in the country. They had some protests going on in 2010 because people were unsatisfied with the way that their country was being led, and that eventually led to a revolution in 2010, which caused some major changes in their political system. The country is now ran by their president, Olafur Ragnar